स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आर टॉपिक ऑफ अल्केलॉयड फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट फार्माकोग्नोसी एंड फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री टू. दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन द आइसोलेशन ऑफ वेरियस केमिकल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स प्रेजेंट इन द प्लांट कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स इन द प्लांट्स वेरियस प्लांट्स लाइक देर आर प्राइमरी मेटाबोलाइट्स, देर आर सेकेंडरी मेटाबोलाइट्स. सो वी हेयर वी विल डिस्कस द सेकेंडरी मेटाबोलाइट दैट इज अल्केलॉयड. First of all, I will discuss about the alkaloid, that what are alkaloid. There are two types of metabolites present in the plants. First are the primary metabolites and second one are the secondary metabolites. What is the role of the primary metabolites? Primary metabolites are required for the proper growth of the plants, whereas the secondary metabolite, these play a very important role in the defense mechanism of plants. So alkaloids are in the category of the plant metabolites. First of all, what are alkaloids? Alkaloids are the organic products of natural or synthetic origin, and these are basic in nature, contain one or more than one nitrogen atom, normally of heterocyclic nature, and these are derived from the various amino acids like indole alkaloids, which are obtained from the tryptophan, or other amino acid like tyrosine or alanine. These are the precursor for the driving the various alkaloids in the plants, and these alkaloids are toxic in nature and possess specific physiological actions on the human body when used in the small quantities. So we will discuss, first of all we will discuss about the various classifications of alkaloid, because in this lecture I will discuss the tropane derivative atropine and purine derivative, that is caffeine. Isse pehle aapko pata hona chahiye ki kin hisab se hum alkaloids ko classify karte hain, kis kis base ke upar, to hum us cheez ko pehle discuss karenge. Jaise jo alkaloids hai unko hum unki pharmacological एक्टिव के आधार पे हम उसको करते हैं कैटेगराइज. लाइक जैसे मॉर्फिन, मॉर्फिन इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एनाल्जेसिक. नेक्स्ट कम टू एट्रोपीन, दिस इज अ यूज्ड एज अ एंटीटसिव एजेंट, और दिस इज एंटीकोलिनर्जिक एजेंट, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो बेस्ड अपॉन द फार्माकोलॉजिकल एक्टिविटी, नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी इज टैक्सोनॉमिक क्लासिफिकेशन मीन्स वी डिवाइड द अल्केलॉयड ऑन द बेस ऑफ द फैमिली विच इज रिप्रेजेंट और द जीनस. लाइक सोलिनेसी, यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट द सोलिनेसी फैमिली, दतूरा, हायोसाइमस, बेलाडोना. These are the drugs which come under a particular family. Fine. Next, if we will talk about the chemical classification of the drugs, in the chemical classification, firstly we will divide the alkaloids on basis of true, proto and pseudo alkaloids. So you should know the difference between the true alkaloid, proto alkaloid and pseudo alkaloids. True alkaloids are the alkaloids which have a nitrogen atom in its heterocyclic ring, and these are derived from the amino acid like tryptophan or tyrosine, alanine, that their precursor in the biosynthetic pathway should be a amino acid. Next, if we will talk about the protoalkaloids, under these categories, protoalkaloids, there are the protoalkaloids which do not have nitrogen atom in their heterocyclic ring, but these are derived from the amino acids, means amino acid is the precursor for that particular amino acid. Alkaloid. Next, talk about the pseudo alkaloids. Pseudo alkaloids have the nitrogen atom in their heterocyclic ring, but these are not derived from the amino acid. That's why these are known as false alkaloids. Fine. Under the true alkaloid, there are the few examples like morphine, atropine. Fine. And first of all, I also want to tell you the role of alkaloid in the plants. Alkaloids are the end products of the various detoxification mechanisms in the plants, and these also play a little role in the growth of plant, not like a primary alkaloid, but these have a very effective pharmacological activities which are used for the therapeutic activity. Fine. Here in the under the alkaloid, first is the atropine. Atropine, this is under the category of tropane alkaloid, like I told you, under the chemical classification based upon the chemical moiety. These are further divided into tropane, quinoline, fine, pyrrole, isoquinoline. They are the various moieties, indole. These are the chemical rings you have studied in your medicinal chemistry. There's, and the alkaloids have the basic structure. The chemical constituent have the basic structure containing these moieties. These may be indole derivative, these may be tropane or quinoline. Here we are discussing the atropine. Atropine is category under the category of tropane alkaloid, and the biological source from where it obtained is, it is obtained from the Hyoscyamus niger, which is known as hornbeam, Atropa belladonna, which is known as deadly shade, nightshade, Datura stramonium, which is a thorn apple, and the family is Solanaceae. ये जो हम एट्रोपिन है, इसको हमें सबसे पहले कि हमें इनका क्यों एक्सट्रैक्शन करने की ज़रूरत पड़ती है, इनका एक बहुत ही एक्टिव फार्माकोलॉजिकल एक्टिविटी होती है. प्लांट के अंदर बहुत सारे केमिकल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स होते हैं, लेकिन एक्टिविटी के लिए ज़रूरी क्या होता है कि हम इनको आइसोलेट करें किसी तरीके से. तो आइसोलेट करने के लिए बहुत सारे एक्सट्रैक्शन के मैथड हैं. ठीक है, पहले उनको एक्सट्रैक्ट कर लिया जाता है, फिर डिफरेंट क्रोमैटोग्राफी और स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपिक टेक्निक से हम उनको करैक्टराइज करते हैं, हम उनको अलग करते हैं. ठीक है, जैसे कि मैं आपको बताना चाहूँगी इसके बारे में कि सबसे पहले आपको करनी है एक्सट्रैक्शन. एक्सट्रैक्शन के बहुत सारे मेथड्स हैं. व्हाट इज़ एक्सट्रैक्शन? एक्सट्रैक्शन में हम जैसे परकोलेशन या फिर हम सॉक्सलेट अपरेटस यूज़ करते हैं, मैसरेशन का मेथड यूज़ करते हैं आप, फाइन, और आप यूज़ करते हैं इन्फ्यूज़न, डिकॉक्शन. दे आर द वेरियस मैथड्स विच आर यूज टू एक्सट्रैक्ट द फाइटो कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स फ्रॉम अ प्लांट मटीरियल, फ्रॉम अ क्रूड ड्रग. देन there are so many constituents present which have different pharmacological activity, and if we need a specific component, we will extract it with the solvents in which that particular compound have a solubility, and then what we will do, we will do the analytical techniques. We will use chromatography, we will use spectroscopy, we will use spectroscopy. Like in chromatography, what do you do? We will use TLC, that is a thin layer chromatography, HPTLC, high performance thin layer chromatography, HPLC, column chromatography. So many methods, analytical techniques we use to differentiate these compounds. And then what we will do, we will want to know what is the compound, what are the groups present in that particular compound. So for that we will use the spectroscopic methods. In the spectroscopic method, there are IR, okay, then NMR, that is nuclear magnetic resonance, you have heard about this, there are UV spectroscopy, there are so many methods with which we can differentiate a particular phytoconstituent, and we can use for this for the therapeutic activity. Fine, we will discuss the atropine in this. Atropine is a tropane alkaloid, as I have told you, and this belongs to Solanaceae family. We can extract the atropine for the Datura. You have heard about the Datura. or this hyoscyamus, but mainly we use hyoscyamus as a crude drug for the isolation of atropine on the commercial basis. Fine. So, first of all, what are the uses of atropine? Atropine is an anticholinergic drug. That means this will act against the cholinergic activity. This is a myodratic, which myodratic means which dilate the pupil of the eye. This is an antidote in opium poisoning. Atropine, if we will talk about the isolation, atropine is isolated from the use or the powder drug hyoscyamus muticus, and it is, this is a preferred source for the manufacture of atropine because it has high alkaloidin content, and this is a picture of the your hyoscyamus nigra. Next, talk about the atropine. First of all, we should know what is atropine. Atropine sulfate is the most important salt of the atropine that is used commercially. It occurs in the form of colorless crystalline powder, and it's talk about its solubility. It's soluble in water and alcohol, but insoluble in ether and chloroform. Melting point is 115 degree to 116 degree Celsius. And come to its IUPAC name, as I have told you, this have the basic moiety, tropane moiety. So this is a, depending on its classification, chemical classification, this has a tropane moiety with which the groups are attached. Next is the procedure for isolation. In this, we will take a crude drug, we take a weight quantity of crude drug, and then we will powder it and obtain a coarse size particle. We will not get the fine particle. The agar hum usko drug ko grind karte hain, uski size reduction karte hain, that crude drug should have a coarse size particles. Then moisten this powder with the aqueous solution of sodium carbonate, extract the blender mixture in ether, filter the ether extract. First of all, I want to tell you the basic isolation procedure behind the alkaloids. Alkaloids are present as the free bases in the solutions, fine. So first of all, we will treat it with the acid to make it a salt so that they can be soluble in the water, and then again we will treat it with the alkaline, any alkaline media like ammonia, so that they come again free as it acts as a free basis, so that we can extract it with the suitable solvent like chloroform, and the chloroform extract will get the required product which we want to require. Fine. Then when we extract the blended mixture in the ether, filter the ether extract and extract the filtrate with the aqueous acetic acid. Then acidic solution is shaken with the solvent ether to remove the coloring matter. Fine. If like there is a chlorophyll present in the plants, so we have to remove it. Fine. Then separate the both layer and discard the ether layer. How we will separate? We will take a apparatus to separate the both layer. Fine. Then treat the acidic layer with the sodium carbonate to obtain the precipitates of tropane alkaloid. Filter the precipitates and drug to obtain the residue. Dissolve this residue in the diethyl ether, then again filter it and concentrate the filtrate. Then atropine crystals will be separated out from this filtrate. Next, we get the crystals, then we will filter the crystals from the solution, and then again we treat it with the alcohol containing sodium hydroxide solution, so that the hyoscyamine that is obtained is converted to atropine. Okay, you have to remember this thing, that the tropane alkaloids which are extracted by using these solvents are the hyoscyamine which can be converted to atropine by treating with the other solvents, which is indicator. How we will know that hyoscyamine is converted to atropine? This will based upon the optical activity. You know the optical activity of the optical activity, that how solution, when in a solution we get a plane of polarized light, and how it direct to polarized light to right direction or to the left direction, on the basis of which we say that these are dextrorotatory or levorotatory. Fine. solution. And if there is absence of the optical activity, means the solution doesn't rotate the plane of polarized light, that means we get the solution, atropine in the solution. The crude atropine is purified and crystallization using the acetone. We will recrystallize it with using acetone. Fine, this is all about the atropine. Then how we will know that we get the atropine crystal? Is there actually a atropine crystal? First of all, we done the optical activity. Next, we will do the chemical test. What we can do? We can do the chemical test. In chemical test, we do we use so many reagents. Fine, which give the coloring reactions or which give the precipitation reactions. Fine. Next, we can do chromatography, which I have told you earlier. Chromatography, in chromatography there is TLC, there is HPTLC, okay, fine, there is column chromatography, so many chromatography methods we use. What is chromatography? Chromatography is an analytical technique in which we get the separation of the these phytoconstituents based upon the adsorption as well as partition coefficient. Next is if we want to know the further details of the structure of that particular phytoconstituent which we have extracted, we will do the spectroscopy method. And under the spectroscopy, UV, NMR, IR and so on. Fine, these are the different methods. First of all, in for the atropine, we will use the identification test, Vitali-Morin reaction, which is known as. In this reaction, we will take the dilute solution of atropine and add a concentrated nitric acid in it. Fine. Then mixture evaporated to dryness on a steam water bath. Then what will occur? Pale yellow residue powder will be. We will get the pale yellow residue powder. And this residue, when treated with the freshly prepared potassium hydroxide, it will give the violet coloration, which is a indication that the atropine is present in the solution. That we get the constituent which we have extracted is truly atropine. Fine. Next come to the next identification test, Lieberman test, Lieberman-Bouchard test. These are also the tests we will do for this. In Lieberman test, we will take the 2 ml of the test extract, and then in this we will add acetic anhydride and boil it, and then we will treat it with the 0.5 ml of sulfuric acid. What it will give? It will give a blue coloration, which indicate the presence of atropine. Lieberman-Bouchard test, in this test there is a little amendment, means in this we will take 2 ml of the test extract, and then we will add chloroform in it. And then 1 ml acetic anhydride and add 1 drop of sulfuric acid. What is the color indication it will give? It will give the blue, green to red, orange color, which indicate the presence of atropine. Next come to the chromatographic method. Chromatographic method TLC or HPTLC. In this, we will use thin layer chromatography. In this, we will take a stationary phase and a mobile phase. Stationary phase is a silica gel, and mobile phase are the different solvents which are used for the chromatographic purposes. As you know, the TLC, this is based on the adsorption and partition coefficient. Okay, these are the mechanism. And this is analytical technique. In this, we separate as well as analyze the materials. Fine. Also, in this, for the TLC or HPTLC, TLC is the thin layer chromatography, and HPTLC is a high performance thin layer chromatography. What is the difference between these both? The basic difference is the particle size of the silica gel we used. What is silica? Silica is stationary phase, silica gel. Fine. जो एच पी टी एल सी होता है उसमें पार्टिकल साइज़ टी एल के कंपैरेटिवली कम होता है, ठीक है। तो उससे क्या होता है, उससे ज़्यादा एफिशिएंटली हम एनालाइज कर सकते हैं। फाइन, सो दिस स्टेशनरी फेज सिलिका फेज स्टेशनरी फेज सिलिका जेल F254 इज यूज। मोबाइल फेज इज क्लोरोफॉर्म मिथेनॉल वाटर इन द रेशियो 30:15:1.2। एंड वट इज़ द इंफरेंस, वी विल स्प्रे द क्रोमैटोग्राम on with the two naphthol reagent and heat it at a 110 degree Celsius for the 5 minutes, and then scan this TLC plate at the 530 nanometer, and this will give the your inference. Fine. Next come to caffeine is also under the category of alkaloids, and this is under the category of purine alkaloid means this have the basic moiety of protein purine. Fine. Then other example I want to tell you, caffeine, theophylline, xanthine, these all contain the purine alkaloid basic moiety. Biological source, this it is obtained from the dried ripe seeds of Coffea arabica family rubaceae, or it can be obtained from the tea leaves. Okay, fine. These are the coffee berries, and these are the leaves of the tea leaves which we usually used at our home. Fine. We use the dried form, these are the fresh leaves. It is obtained from the tea leaves of Camellia sinensis and family Thiaceae. Next, caffeine. If we talk about the caffeine, tea leaves contain 1-4% of caffeine, whereas the coffee seeds contain 1-2% of caffeine. Uses, this is a psychoactive stimulant drug. Fine. We take a tea in the morning to activate our mind. In the simple language we say we want to stimulate our mind in the morning, and we take the tea. Fine. So caffeine present in the tea is a psychoactive stimulant. Isolation, caffeine is largely produced synthetically. It is usually isolated from the tea leaves or recovered from the coffee seeds during decaffeination process means from the coffee beans we extract out the caffeine. Fine. Caffeine is extracted from the coffee beans by the process of leaching with the water. Next come to caffeine, the highest yield up to 90% was obtained when the coarse coffee powder is extracted with the warm water at 75 degree Celsius, means this gives a high yield. Next, extraction takes place about half an hour with the water and coffee in the ratio of 9:1. Melting point is 235-237 degrees Celsius, and this is a purine moiety, and this is the chemical structure of this caffeine. Procedure for isolation, for this we take the coarse powder of tea leaves is extracted with the boiling water, and then this aqueous extract is hot, we filter it. मीन्स कि जब वो गर्म हो वार्म हो उसी दौरान उसको फिल्टर कर लेना है. द वार्म एक्सट्रैक्ट इज ट्रीटेड विद द लेड एसीटेट सोल्यूशन. वट द लेड एसीटेट विल डू, लेड एसीटेट विल प्रेसिपिटेट द टैनिंस प्रेजेंट इन द टी लीव्स. यू नो द टी हैव अ कलरिंग प्रॉपर्टी. फाइन. टैनिंस आर मेनली नोन फॉर द डाइंग प्रॉपर्टी, because these have these can color the any cloth, or you can say jaise ghar mein hum jaise chai peete hain, chai gir gayi to us pe kya hota hai, color chhod deta hai, theek hai, bahut gehra color chhodta hai, that is due to the presence of the tannins. So sabse pehle hum isme caffeine, kyunki hume obtain karna hai to isme se tannin nikalne padenge, aur tannin kaise nikalenge hum, lead acetate solution ke sath, theek hai, jo tannins hai lead acetate ke sath precipitate nikal jayenge bahar, प्रेसिपिटेट हो जाएंगे, उसके बाद हम इसको फिल्टर करेंगे. देन द एक्सेसिव लेड एसीटेट प्रेजेंट इन द सॉल्यूशन इज प्रेसिपिटेटेड विद द लेड एसीटेट एंड विद द डिल्यूट सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड. सॉल्यूशन इज बॉइल्ड विद अ चारकोल टू रिमूव द कलरिंग मैटर इफ एनी. अगर उसके अंदर कोई और कलरिंग मैटर बचा है तो उसको हम क्या करेंगे, उसको हम दोबारा से चारकोल से, क्योंकि चारकोल क्या करती है, एड्जॉर्ब कर लेती है अपनी सर्फेस के ऊपर. Fine. Filter to remove the charcoal, then we will remove the charcoal from it. The filter decolorized solution is extracted with the chloroform. combined chloroform extract after evaporation contain the caffeine as a white material. Fine, white material कैसे मिलेगा वो हमें, अगर हम उसमें से tannins को निकाल देंगे, कलरिंग मैटर को निकाल देंगे, उसके बाद ही हमें ये white material मिलेगा. Recrystallize it with the alcohol. Fine. After we getting the this caffeine, we will do the identification test. First one is the murexide test and then is the tannic acid test. In murexide test, what will we do? We will treat the caffeine powder with hydrochloric acid and KCl and heat to dryness, expose the residue to dilute ammonia, and it will give purple color. In tannic acid test, we will treat the caffeine with the tannic acid and this will give the white precipitate. Next, come to chromatography analytical technique, TLC and HPTLC. TLC is again, this is a chromatographic technique in which we use the stationary phase silica gel G, mobile phases chloroform methanol in the ratio 9:1. And how we'll detect it? We will spray the iodine vapors, we will and visible the brown spot present. Ki jo aapki jaise chromatography plate hai. Fine, chromatography plate mein hum kya karte hain? Yahan pe hum हमने स्पॉट लगाए, ठीक है, ये आपका एल्यूजन साथ में रन करेगा क्रोमैटोग्राफ के साथ, मोबाइल फेज के साथ, ठीक है. मोबाइल फेज में आप रखते हो अपनी इसको, तो उससे क्या होगा कि ये जो आपने स्पॉट लगाए, ये जो स्पॉट यहाँ पे आ गए हैं, दीज विल गिव द कलर. फाइन, व्हेन वी स्प्रे एनी रिएजेंट ऑन इट. फाइन, एंड नेक्स्ट इज द HPLC. HPLC इज अ हाई परफॉर्मेंस लिक्विड क्रोमैटोग्राफी. दिस इज अनदर टेक्निक अंडर द क्रोमैटोग्राफिक टेक्निक. इन दिस मेथड वी यूज द आइसोक्रेटिक स्टेशनरी फेज, दैट इज द C18. दिस इज द आइसोक्रेटिक टाइप. ओके, आइसोक्रेटिक. HPLC इज ऑफ टू टाइप, आइसोक्रेटिक एंड ग्रेडियंट. आइसोक्रेटिक मीन्स कि वी यूज द मोबाइल फेज सेम कंसिस्टेंसी, वी विल नॉट, दैट इज अल्यूजन मटीरियल विच वी विल यूज द सेम कंसिस्टेंसी. ग्रेडियंट में क्या होता है कि सेम कंसिस्टेंसी नहीं रहती, हम चेंज भी कर सकते हैं. तो जो हम इसमें यूज़ करेंगे वो हम आइसोक्रेटिक टाइप ऑफ करेंगे. आइसोक्रेटिक HPLC टेक्निक यूज़ करेंगे और उसमें हम स्टेशनरी फेज लेंगे C18, मोबाइल फेज मिथेनॉल वाटर 25:75, एंड वी विल गेट द अब्जॉर्प्शन अंडर द UV विजिबल डिटेक्शन एट द 254 नैनोमीटर. सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द टेक्निक्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ विच वी कैन टेल दैट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट विच वी हैव एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द टी लीव्स ऑफ द कॉफी बीन्स इज द कैफीन. फाइन, and there are another techniques. If we want to know the structure formula, you want to know the molecular mass, you can use the mass spectroscopy for getting the molecular weight. And if you want to know the functional groups present on it, you can use another spectroscopy method like NMR, that is a nuclear magnetic resonance. Thank you.